Welcome. Let's define what biostatistics means. In statistics, we collect, organize, and analyze information from a scenario or study so we can understand that scenario better. The bio part of biostatistics refers to the fact that we're studying biological data, especially data relating to human biology, public health, and medicine. For example, we can start with a group of people, collect information about those people, turn the information into numbers, analyze those numbers, and use those findings to better understand that group of people. Variables are characteristics that vary from one person to another in a population or group. Using biostatistics, the goal is to understand the interrelationships between these variables. How do they relate to one another? A researcher conducting a study on a sample of individuals from a population will decide what variables are important to study. A variable used to describe other variables is called an independent variable. It is the starting point from which you describe every other variable. For example, if you are interested in studying smoking and the effect smoking has on health, then smoking would be your independent variable. Your study would investigate what illnesses people would get that are related to smoking. Your dependent variables, in this example, would be all the illnesses you find when you study your sample. You might find lung cancer, stroke, or heart disease. These are examples of dependent variables. Finally, you would have to consider all the things called covariates that impact your study and change the relationship between the independent and dependent variables. In this example, these covariates could be genetics, air pollution, age, and gender. All this information will be stored, imported into a statistical computing tool such as R, and then be analyzed with the biostatistical skills that we will learn. Using the tools of biostatistics, we help answer pressing research questions in public health, such as whether a new drug works, what causes cancer and other diseases, and how long a person with a certain illness is likely to survive. Now, we will hear from two former MPH students in biostatistics and myself, and learn how we applied biostatistical skills to real-world research projects in health policy, childhood cancer, and genetics.
With biostatistical skills acquired here at OSU, I was able to take a lot of messy data and filter it into some results that are now being published.
With biostatistics, I've been able to explore the relationship between biology and disease. In my current project, we're examining how C-section status and birth defects may affect the risk of childhood cancers.
My research is focused on studying the relationship between genetics and complex human traits, which can be human diseases or any other human conditions.
Working with two faculty members here at OSU, we wanted to assess whether recreational marijuana legalization in Oregon, or RML, was associated with an increase in marijuana use relative to other states without RML.
So far, we've replicated the findings from another research group and expanded our analysis to include factors they hadn't considered yet.
With the advance of high-throughput sequencing technologies, we are now able to quantify and store variations in human genome.
It's actually pretty rewarding to use most of my biostatistical skills to first clean this messy data set, something that could actually be used for research, and secondly, to create graphical images that condense this million-plus data set in something you could actually visually comprehend.
My job is to build and develop advanced statistical models to pinpoint which variations play an influential role in such human traits.
And lastly, to use the regression techniques that I've learned here to find out if what we were seeing visually was being supported by statistically significant results.
The goal of my research is to uncover the genetic architecture behind exceptional longevity.
Our work is still in progress, but we hope to shine a light on the underlying biological mechanisms responsible for childhood cancers.
These are skills I didn't have before earning my degree here at OSU, and I believe they will be valuable to my future as a biostatistician.
We hope you're excited to see how data makes all the differences when studying human biology, public health, and medicine. Let's turn data into knowledge.